Your Gmail contains some of the most personal information about you and is hands down the most vulnerable link in your online security profile. More than likely, some document that you've sent or received in your email contains your full name, your address, even your social security number or ID number. It doesn't matter how empty your bank account is, this information can easily be used to maliciously steal your identity, destroy your credit, and even lock you out of your online accounts. In other words, the five simple steps for securing your Gmail account that I'm about to share with you, steps that really should only take you a few minutes to implement, they aren't just something to consider someday. It's critical that you do this right now. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and as somebody who's personally had their Gmail account hacked in the past, I can tell you from experience just how annoying and time-consuming it is to recover from this kind of attack. You don't want to have to go through that. Trust me. By the way, this video is sponsored by Yubikey, a company I'm really proud to represent, and there's a very good reason for that, which I'll explain in a moment. For now, let's just go ahead and jump into your Gmail settings. I hate that I even have to share this as a step, but if you don't have a strong password, please change it right now. A strong password is a random combination of characters, the longer, the better, that is unique, meaning that you only use that password for Gmail and not a single other online login. To change your Gmail password, go to myaccount.google.com/security and click on password under signing into Google. Make sure you create a better password that you won't forget and that isn't used anywhere else. Now that you're in your security settings of your Gmail account, you may have noticed a few warnings under the security checkup box. Even if Google gives you a pat on the back with your message reading, your account is protected, I still recommend you jump over to the security checkup page. I'll have a link in the description, or you can just type in what you see here on the screen. It's really important to know what you can do with this tool that Google provides, both from a monitoring and from a threat avoidance standpoint. For example, I can check all of the devices that are listed as trusted to open my Gmail account and to make sure that there aren't any unknown devices that I can tell Google that I don't recognize. Or better yet, let's say that my phone was stolen or lost. This allows me to quickly jump in and tell Google to sign that device out so that nobody will have access to my email, even if they're able to get into that device. In my opinion, probably the most important change that you can make to secure your Gmail account is to turn on two-factor authentication. As you can see here, I have multiple security keys as well as the Gmail prompt set up as my two-factor authentication, or 2FA for short. Now, let me stop and say this. If you take away only one thing from this video, I want it to be this. Gmail security does not exist without 2FA. In other words, if you're not using 2FA, even if you have the strongest password in the world, your account security is at high risk. I'm not trying to scare you, I'm just telling you the truth. There are many ways that you can activate 2FA, including SMS text, authenticator apps, and even backup codes. Thankfully, the most secure way to do this is also the easiest to set up. And that's where Yubikey, the sponsor for this video, comes in. If you followed me here for any amount of time, you know that I don't take on many sponsors for this channel. And the truth is, Yubikey didn't reach out to me. I reached out to them, basically saying, I use your 2FA keys, I love them, let's work together. You see, I own a few of their 2FA keys, including one that I keep on my keychain, which works for my computer and Apple phone, the backup that I keep in an undisclosed location, and the new bio, which uses fingerprint authentication. And there are plenty of 2FA keys that you can find on Amazon, but when it comes to this kind of security, I am very picky about who I trust. You can use the Yubikey security key to secure not only your Gmail account, but also any other account that supports the FIDO protocol, and there are plenty of them out there. If you don't have your own 2FA key yet, or perhaps you don't have a backup, Yubikey's offering a special discount on their affordable security key series so that you can buy a couple of your own. You'll find links in the description of this video. Personally, I bought four, a primary and a backup for myself as well as for my wife. I promise you, this is an investment in your security that you can't afford not to make. I know that's a double negative, and basically what I'm trying to say is that you need to do this. The process of setting up a 2FA key on your Gmail account is pretty straightforward. Log into your Gmail account, go to myaccount.google.com/security. you scroll down and find two-step verification. You need to turn that on if you haven't already. They call it two-step instead of two-factor. Anyway, you want to add that security key. Of course, you'll already need to have purchased your key, but once you have your YubiKey device in hand, you'll click on USB and then register the key by plugging it into your computer or device. Name it whatever you want, and then you're done. You can remove these keys from your account at any time, which is useful if you somehow lose that key or it gets stolen or something like that. Now, anytime that you log into your email on a new device, you'll need to plug in this key to verify that it is, in fact, your account. But that's exactly what you want to do. Important side note here, whenever you use any kind of 2FA, you need to make sure you have a backup plan. This could be a second key, backup codes that you store securely, or something else. The last thing you want, though, is to lock yourself out of your Gmail account. An important step in security checkup after 2FA is to review third-party access. Over the years, we all allow certain apps or websites to have access to our account, and we often forget to remove them when we're done using that particular service. For example, you can see here that at some point, I allowed Word Cloud for Documents to have access to my account. Since I don't use that service anymore, I'll go ahead and remove access for them. You should do the same to any apps or sites that you don't recognize, and don't worry. If you make a mistake, they can always request new access, and you can grant it to them. So again, don't worry. Now, for those of you who want an extra measure of security, and don't worry, I'm not judging you because I do this, you can enroll in what Google calls its Advanced Protection Program. It's free to sign up, and although it was designed with activists and journalists in mind, it's really open to anybody. Essentially, the Advanced Protection Program forces you to use a 2FA key, which I've already said is the one thing you need to be doing anyway. In addition to 2FA, a Gmail account enrolled in this program performs stringent checks on file downloads, app installs, malware, etc. Honestly, I can't think of a good reason not to enroll in this free program unless you just refuse to buy a required 2FA key. But since I know you care about locking down your Gmail account, a 2FA key is a no-brainer investment. Make sure you grab your own set of YubiKey 2FA keys using the special discount link below this video, and then share this with your family and friends who you know need to enhance their own Gmail security. Oh yeah, and if you want help setting up your YubiKey on other accounts besides just Gmail, make sure you watch this tutorial next. Click right here.